Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Millennium Events presenting MMA Explosion. Dave Farrell alongside Joey Varner at the joint inside the Hard Rock in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada. Joey, tonight we got some great fights, don't we?
Dude, it is going down. I'm telling you, I'm so excited. We got UFC vet Justin Wren coming back on our show. Got a Jorge Little Monster Lopez from Van Fight Team, man. I'm so excited to see him.
First fighters making their way to the ring right now. Another very exciting fighter on the card tonight is Chidi Njokuani. If that last name sounds familiar, it's because his big brother is in the WEC.
Absolutely. Chidi Njokuani, the younger brother of WEC vet Anthony Njokuani. And talking beforehand to his coach, One Kick Nick, he told me that if Chidi does anything close to what he's doing in the gym, then this should be a very fast and very successful night for him.
Yeah, lots of knockouts potentially on the card tonight. And we'll start the evening with a ladies' fight. First up this evening, you see Amy the Animal Stacy right there making her way, getting the final preparations done before she steps into the ring. She came all the way from Oklahoma.
Yeah, and she is an animal. I love it. She's fighting out of Anderson Stacy Bone Breaking Academy. Excuse me, let me say that again. Anderson Stacy Bone Breaking Academy.
And I asked if that was the legit name of their gym, and she looked at me, didn't even face her. She's like, absolutely, that's the real name of our academy. I love it. Now, her opponent tonight is a tough one as well, but I tell you, there's something about Amy. You can just look at certain fighters and see that they mean business. You know, they're not flying around the country taking these fights just for the fun of it. They're coming out here to get a job done. That's the look that I see in Amy's eyes. And with a nickname like the Animal, you gotta figure that she means business, right?
Dude, look over there.
What?
She is so ready. Look at the corner right there.
Yeah. You hear the crowd eating it up. That's Michelle La Diabla Gutierrez making her way to the ring right now from Juan Fight Team as well. This is in the 120-pound women's division, and something about Michelle is she has not only got a lot of fans, but she is prepared. That's what all of her friends, all of her coaches say. She is coming into this fight tonight absolutely 100% ready.
There's nothing more excited to me than when I see both fighters and I talk to both their camps and they tell me that their fighter is so ready, is so hungry, they're coming out to make a big statement and make an impact. And when I hear that from both camps, usually what we get is fireworks.
And you look at Michelle Gutierrez there and she's got a solid corner. I mean, you see the people that are hugging her right there. Vanderlei Silva is in her corner. Does it get much better than that? Is there anyone more experienced in the fight game that you'd rather have in your corner than Vanderlei Silva? All right, it is time, ladies and gentlemen. Our first fight of the evening, Michelle Gutierrez taking on Amy Stacy.
And now, fight fans, it's time to begin our first bout of the night. Scheduled for three rounds in the women's 120-pound division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a mixed martial artist with a professional record of 0 wins with 2 losses. She stands 5'2" tall, weighing in at 120 pounds. Fighting out of Norman, Oklahoma, Amy the Animal Stacy. And now, introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a mixed martial artist with a professional record of 0 wins with 1 loss. She stands 5'6" tall, weighing in at 121 pounds. Fighting out of One Fight Team, Michelle La Diabla Gutierrez. And when this fight begins, your referee in charge is Chris Tione.
Once again, the focus, the determination on both of their faces. There's something about Amy, though. She looks very calm. Good thing or a bad thing, in your opinion?
You know what? Before I saw Michelle La Diabla, before I saw Michelle come out, I thought it was a good thing. But now looking over there, Amy kind of looks like a deer in the headlights. She looks a little like she might be kind of spooked right now. As Michelle, you see her just light on her toes. She's ready to come out. She's got an intense focus, you know, kind of look on her face.
Yeah, and Michelle has a distinct height and reach advantage in this fight. Let's see how it plays out. If Michelle's going to try to... Nice takedown, though, by Amy.
And Michelle pops up right away. She's trying to establish that clinch. She lets go of the clinch and cracks her a couple times. Amy didn't like it. Amy's eating punches. She had a big knee to the body. And that's how she wrote.
Okay, when Michelle Gutierrez's camp said that she was ready, I think they were right on this one.
I think she might be ready to fight a couple more people.
That was less than 30 seconds. It looked like that first punch just clipped Amy, and she had almost no answer for it. Right away, it was over.
She got hit.
Do it.
Yeah, she got caught, dude. She looked away. She wanted none of it from that point. She started to run. Before the referee could even jump in, Michelle was all over, landing that big right hand and a big knee to the body.
Let's take a look right here. Here's that big knee that you were talking about. She fought her with that a couple of rights. Okay, that was even after the knee, and then that big right is...
There's the knee I'm talking about.
The knee.
That was that knee.
Put her right on the ground.
Yeah, that was it. She did not want to be in there after that.
Look at Vanderlei Silva right there talking to her, giving her the congratulations. It's funny when you've got an 8-week fight camp and you go through it to get prepared for a fight like this, and then it ends in less than 30 seconds. It's exactly what you want, but exactly what you don't want at the same time. You don't get any payoff, you know?
Exactly, dude. You know what? It seems like when that happens, there's this burden lifting off your shoulders, this great feeling of relief. But then afterwards, you're like, dang, I kind of wanted to see how my conditioning is. I wanted to test myself and go a little far. But nothing can take the place of that feeling when you knock someone out and you stop them in a fight.
And you can tell the endorphins are just rushing right now. For Michelle. She's so happy, elated, literally dancing around in the ring. It's a lot better when a girl does it after a win as opposed to a guy.
Yeah, no,
I don't know if I want to see Justin Wren dancing around later.
Yeah.
Let's take it up to our ring announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Chris Tione has called a stop to this fight at 17 seconds into round number one, declaring the winner by TKO, Michelle Lil Diabla Gutierrez.
Exciting way to start the night, is it not, Joey V?
Yeah, definitely. And you know what? I actually remember looking at Michelle now. I remember seeing her box a couple times, and dude, she's got some great hands. I think she's got a big lot of potential, a lot of growth in this sport.
Yeah, her first fight in the ring, she lost. This fight, she comes out, wins in dominating fashion. She is now 1-1. And what a great way to go back into another training camp. You know, you're just on such a high. You perform so well. But it's tough to see exactly where you need to improve because it went so quickly. But what a great way to start the evening for Michelle Gutierrez.
Definitely. Look at her. She's all smiles. Look at that. She loves it, dude.
All right, we're rounding it out with another fight. This one in the men's 130-pound division. That's coming up next from the joint at the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. MMA Explosion continues in just a moment.
Today, and happy to do it.